Hello again, everyone. Marcus here. I review stuff. Today, I'm reviewing the song Everlasting Love by Rufus and Chaka Khan. Now, doing something a little bit different today. This does not come as a request from one of my viewers. Instead, what I'm doing right now is I'm making my way through Rolling Stone's top 500 albums of all time. And right now, we're on number 499, Ask Rufus by Rufus featuring Chaka Khan. So the way it works is I plan on listening to maybe two, at the most, maybe three songs from each album on this list. Doing a video for, I guess, two or three songs, I should say, and then listening to the rest of the album just on my own time and letting you guys know what I think. And so before we jump into the song, I just want to preface it by saying that the whole point of my channel was to expose myself to more music that I maybe would not have otherwise listened to. You know, I found that I tend to just listen to the same thing over and over again, and I was not often listening to newer artists or even artists that were new to me. And so since starting the channel, I've listened to so much more music that I probably would have never been exposed to otherwise. And so I definitely owe all of my viewers a debt of gratitude for all the requests over the last few years. But with that said, a lot of the requests that I get from my viewers do kind of fit within that rock and roll vein. And so, the last album, number 500 on this list, was Arcade Fire's Funeral, which, fantastic album, of course. And honestly, maybe it needs to be rated a little bit higher. We'll see in the future. But that is an album that I probably would have listened to some songs off of it eventually. You know, people have requested Arcade Fire before on the channel. I just haven't quite gotten to them yet. But this album, Rufus, Ask Rufus, I don't think anyone who typically views my channel would have requested any songs from this ever. And so what I really like about kind of approaching this list this way is that it's going to now expose me to music that even people on my YouTube channel would not have exposed me to. And so, yeah, I guess what I'm trying to say is this is something a little bit different that we wouldn't normally listen to on the channel, and I'm really excited to do so. So I say we jump right in. Again, this is Everlasting Love, Rufus featuring Chaka Khan. Let's listen. So far, so good. I'm digging this.
Mystifying love.
That is catchy. I like that a whole lot. Oh man, I like that a whole lot. And again, it just solidifies my decision. It sort of reinforces and justifies my decision to do this because it's like I love that, and I probably would have never sought that out on my own, or had it kind of come across my listening habits on my own. And I highly doubt anyone on my channel would have ever requested that song. And that's not to knock on anyone on my channel. You guys request some fantastic stuff. But, again, there is a pattern to what gets requested, and stuff like that is not typically what comes up. So, man, I am so glad that I decided to try out this idea. Just for that alone, it's already paid off. So, anyway, one thing I did forget to do, I knew I was forgetting something. I like to read the little description that Rolling Stone has here. So, about the album, it says, fronted by Chaka Khan, one of soul music's most combustible singers, Rufus built its mid-70s sound on heavy-footed, guitar-slathered funk. I think that's a really good way to put it. But after spending 16 months in the studio working on Ask Rufus, they came out with a record that gave their songs more room to breathe. Anticipating the lithe, loose arrangements of 90s neo-soul, Khan glided through the head-nodding Everlasting Love and the twisty-turny Better Days. It's probably going to be the one I do next. And fans appreciated the adjustment. Ask Rufus was the group's first platinum record. So obviously a lot of success for this one. And I can see why. Man, that song was so damn good. So anyway, let's break it down piece by piece like we always do, of course, starting with the lyrics. So, when I feel you dreaming, I think of sunsets, how high my high gets. I want to give you an everlasting love. I want to fill your life with a satisfying love. All you need is an everlasting love. All you want is a satisfying love. Summer breezes, moonlight teases, friendly invasion, late night persuasion. Yeah, I mean, to me, this song is just about exactly that, everlasting love, finding that person that you really, really love. And again, even when you're just laying next to them sleeping, you just think of how great that person is for your life and wanting to fulfill them with, your love, essentially. Summer breezes, moonlight teases, friendly invasion, late night persuasion. I want to give you an everlasting love. I want to fill your life with a satisfying love. All you need is an everlasting love. All you want is my satisfying love. I don't know what the oh, mystifying. Sorry, I read it and my satisfying. I was like, did they mess up here? I messed up. All you want is a mystifying love. Each time you pass me by, you slowly fade away. I need you more each day. Wow. Each time you pass me by, you slowly fade away. And so I wonder if that's just like the passage of time, like we're spending our lives together, but the passage of time means that, each day means I have less time with you, which is really sad to think about, but essentially, wanting that love to last forever. I want to give you an everlasting love. I want to fill your life with a satisfying love. All you need is an everlasting love. All you want is a mystifying love. I want to give you an everlasting love. I want to fill your life with a satisfying love. Kind of goes on like that for some time. But man, I dug that lyrically. Again, I think it's just about being in love. And I think it really nails that down lyrically. So for me, I give it a thumb up. As far as the lyricism goes, as far as the instrumentation and vocals go, I gotta say, I'll start with Chaka Khan. I really like her vocal style here. Just absolutely gorgeous vocals. Really like the harmonizing. I don't know if it was her voice layered over itself or if there were backup singers essentially, but really, really love her approach to singing this one. Just so smooth and just easy to listen to. So, yeah, I wanna see. Okay, apparently this song is sampled by Can of Corn by Coolio. I don't think I've ever heard that one. There's also been covers by Mary J. Blige, Vanessa Williams, and Jay Spencer. So this is probably a lot more well-known than I realize, I suppose. But yeah, again, Chaka Khan, I think her approach to the vocals was fantastic. She really hit some really awesome notes there throughout the song, but also knew when to kind of draw it back and just be real mellow and chill with it, let it groove out. So really loved the instrumentation as well. I think the bass line throughout was very groovy, very funky, very easy to listen to. Love the guitar as well. I mean, you had it kind of come in whenever Chaka Khan would sort of step off the vocals, guitar would kind of come in and keep grooving you out. But everything else, I think, worked fantastic. The chimes, you know, kind of came in the right moments. Everything just really, really worked for me. It was very groovy, very fun to listen to. I mean, it's just one of those that gets you moving, and you can just kind of put on and enjoy. So, yeah, instrumentally, vocally, I give this one two big thumbs up. I had a great time listening to it. As far as replay value goes, this one easily makes the playlist. I think lyrically, again, it's pretty straightforward. It's a song, I think, about just being in love. But I think vocally and instrumentally, this one really takes it up there. So many nice little pieces to grab onto, whether it's the bass, the guitar, Chaka Khan's vocals. I mean, I just think everything really, really works for this one. It's just such a fun listen. So groovy, so easy to just get lost in, which I feel like I did for a good stretch of it. I was just like, oh, I'm just jamming out. I really need to pay attention so I have something to say afterwards. But yeah, this one was fantastic. So, like I said, two thumbs up instrumentally and vocally, and two thumbs up for replay value. Can't wait to put it on the playlist and listen to it again. So yeah, hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. Can't wait to listen to the next one off of this album, which again, I'll probably do Better Days since it just kind of mentions it by name here in the Rolling Stone article. But yeah, I enjoyed it and I hope I continue to enjoy the rest of the album. Again, I'll only do videos for maybe one or two songs, and then from there I'll listen to the rest of the album on my own. So, all right, like I said, hope you enjoyed it. You know, still taking requests as always. Leave them in the comments while you're down there. Feel free to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and check the description where you can find links to follow me on Twitch, Twitter, or TikTok. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye for now.